Welcome back to another Crafty Workshop Builds video. Today, we're going to be replacing a cam follower in a B7 Audi A4. And please go ahead and hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, and stay tuned. This is what comes in the kit. Three bolts, an O-ring, and the cam follower. And these are essentially what I'll be replacing. I'm going to remove the two PCV breather hoses to make room to work. I will start with this short one at the top. I removed the two sockets on the high pressure fuel pump. This connector at the bottom can be a little bit tricky to remove. If you find it too difficult to remove, you may choose to skip this step and try to work around it when you're removing the banjo bolt. These are the tools that I use to remove the connector at the bottom. I use a pick tool to press the valve and release the fuel before removing the valve. I use a 13mm wrench to remove the valve. I removed this vacuum hose to make room to use the wrench on the fuel line. Then I'm going to loosen the nut with a 17mm wrench. Now I'm going to remove the banjo bolt with an 8mm triple square socket with an extension. I use a T30 Torx bit socket to remove the three bolts that are holding on the high pressure fuel pump. The idea is to equally unscrew the three bolts at the same time. Now it's time to remove the cam follower once the pump is out. As you can see, the old cam follower seems to be in good shape, but it's still a good idea to replace it before it goes bad. I removed the old O-ring and installed the new one. This is the old cam follower compared to the new one. I added some oil on the cam follower before installing. This will help to prevent premature wear when I first start the engine. I reinstalled the high pressure fuel pump and tightened the three bolts equally. I tightened the banjo bolt and the nut on the fuel lines. Now I'm gonna install the breather hose. I reinstalled the pressure valve, and now I'm going to reconnect the two sockets on the high pressure fuel pump. Now I'll reconnect the small breather hose, then replace the engine cover. Alright, that's it for this one. If you are getting value from this channel and you wish to support what I do, please go ahead and check out my website in the description. And thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.